from the Broadcast House Studios at 44th and O, morning radio for the entire capital city. This is LNK Today with Jack and friends on the Voice of Lincoln, 1400 KLIN.
Hey, welcome back, LNK Today with Jack and friends on KLIN. You know, I need to mention it here. Don't forget, you need a little respite from things. And I think we all do right now. You want to already like the KLIN Facebook page just because we've got so much news on it right now. But you can also vote on Munch Madness Classic, which is going on right now, brought to you by the University of Nebraska Federal Credit Union. I'll tell you what. There are some people who say, Jack, you should really do a bracket with restaurants people can go to. I'm not saying anything. So you can vote there. By the way, up today, we had Kings knock off the Pantry in the first round. Kuhl's knocked off Alice's, so they'll match up. The matchup's today. Miller and Payne versus the Dairy Suite and Bishop's Buffet versus Crane River. And go to the KLIN Facebook page. And thanks again to University of Nebraska Federal Credit Union for sponsoring Munch Madness Classic, which has not been canceled. All right, it is time to go to the phones, which we're going to be doing more often with our guests, even the ones who come in studio, because we're trying to take responsible steps like hopefully all of you are as well. And as we've been joined over the last decade by this guest, Jason Peterson from Generate Marketing, I call him our tech gadgets and social media marketing guru. How's it going, Jason?
Good morning, Jack. How are you doing, sir?
Not too bad. Just trying to trying to keep people informed, trying to keep everybody hanging together and give some people some things to smile about every once in a while. I'm curious. I know your business, your work is working with small businesses and helping them market themselves right now. Give us a sense of what that world is like for you.
Well, I think, you know, right now, obviously, it's a complicated time because, you know, each of our companies that we help, they're trying to figure out what to talk about. I mean, I think we're all trying to decide, like you said, that, you know, we have to still continue on with our lives, but we can't ignore the challenges that we're all facing. So, you know, I think right now the big thing we've been trying to help businesses with is, you know, first and foremost, you don't want to go dark. I think that's the thing that, you know, is a risk because, you know, ultimately we want to continue to still provide a presence. So I think, you know, as I've always told our clients from day one is the customers we have that do the best are the ones that show that they care, in general, about the people they serve and they take care of, but the community as a whole. So, certainly it's not a message of trying to take advantage of the situation, but I think most definitely this is, you know, for the lack of a better term, an opportunity, but it's a time where, people want to know that there's, you know, I think people out there that are trying to step up, come up with solutions, and just, you know, knowing that, hey, this is what matters to us. I mean, as the clients that I've met with and stuff, and I think that's to me in general, is that some of the really heavy salesy things, I mean, again, our economy has to somehow continue to move forward. But again, ultimately, you know, I think the good thing about digital, and again, I think it's for all the things that can kind of be, you know, nasty on social and stuff, it's a chance to help the community know. And I mean, you and I know, I mean, we're born and raised in Lincoln, that I think that's the thing that I've always been impressed is our community steps up. People, you know, are trying. I know, like last night, I posted on Facebook, so my mom, bless her heart, she's teaching my kids piano. She's been teaching piano, or she kind of retired, did it for like 45 years. So we set up a little FaceTime and sat there, and she did a piano lesson with my kids while they were, you know, sitting at the keyboard. And, you know, everybody responded. And I mean, it wasn't, you know, me trying to draw attention, but it was like, you know what? What we have to do in these times is, Even though it would be ideal to have face to face, is continue to try to connect with community and try to use some of those technology efficiencies that allow you to still connect. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's not ideal, but maybe be more intentional in using some of the social and those kind of things as a power for good.
So let's talk. I know we've got a lot of people listening who perhaps for the first time are working from home, or at very least are home a lot more often than they usually are. And by the way, first off, on the radio side of things, I want to remind people, I know we've said it a lot, but if you're at home, you're like, man, I'm always listening when I'm driving. I'm not driving now. Not only, obviously, we're on the radio at home, but if you don't have access to that, you can go through your Amazon Alexa, enable the KLIN skill, and you can listen on that. You can listen, you can download an app on any of your phones. Just search KLIN. You listen to our podcast, which we're continuing to put up. You can listen through the website. There are scads of ways, so please keep listening on that. Now, Jason, in terms of just other kind of efficiencies and hacks and things people maybe should know when they're at home from kind of a technological side, what are some of the things you think people should get themselves acquainted with right now?
Well, I think the biggest thing I would say is we're in an era where the video conferencing stuff is extremely easy to use, whether it's FaceTime, whether it's Skype, Zoom conferencing, sometimes the business side. We actually use the Google Hangouts part of the business part. But, you know, we've been kind of fortunate. We've been using that since day one. We have a couple gals that lived here for a long time that then moved internationally. And they've been, one of those, my primary web developer, you know, she lives in Malaysia. And she's been doing video conferencing with my clients for the last 2 years. So point is that I think first and foremost, that's, it may seem awkward to those that maybe haven't done that. I mean, like I said, I always prefer to have people in the same room with me. But that can be used in a personal and professional level, and it can be very cost effective. So to me, that's probably one of the first things you can do is, you know, use those tools so that, you know, it allows you guys to communicate, you know, when you're having meetings, obviously. But even to some, it's just kind of, some of them are liking it just to have it on. I know using chats, I mean, again, it's kind of ironic in some of the comments and things that I've read is, you know, it's like adopting some of like the Gen Z millennial concepts of, you know, we used to make fun of people where they would like send an instant message like across the room where that's okay now. Like that's kind of, you know, for those that are not, chatting back and forth. We use Google Hangouts all the time. I know Slack is a really popular tool that's, I believe, owned by Microsoft. It's kind of like an ongoing sort of like bulleted board kind of chat.
Tons of workplaces. Tons of workplaces use Slack. I know. I hear people talk about it all the time. I've used it briefly. So for people who don't know what it is, can you just give a little bit more explanation how it might be handy if you're working at home or even just at home significantly?
Well, I think, you know, as you and I know, or definitely for me, email could be like the bottomless pit. And Slack's attempt, like we use Basecamp, but it's more of a means of trying to minimize the use of email and having real-time interaction that's focused on specific projects, topics, initiatives, all those kinds of things that it's meant to be somewhat of a project management, but it isn't necessarily that. It's more of a messaging system that allows you to collaborate and visit. It can have real-time conversation. Again, it can integrate with Skype because Skype is also owned by Microsoft. But again, I think, you know, this kind of stuff, it exists. I mean, the good news we live in, Jack, is there's a lot of, you know, very affordable, easy to use tech that's been around now for a while that, you know, both from a personal, like I did last night, and a professional that you can take advantage of. You know, I think another article I was listening to about how, you know, they were having like a virtual happy hour. I'm not really sure how you pull that off, but I heard some businesses were like, again, having people like all on video and they were all, normally usually a company that worked. It was actually a marketing firm that was not located in Lincoln. And they were all like having a beer, hanging out, all on video. So again, sounds super stupid, but truthfully, I think we're just going to need to be more intentional about looking at some of these little simple efficiencies and trying to, like I said, adapt and evolve. And it might be uncomfortable, But I think it's super important right now that we still try to look at ways that we can connect with each other.
Jason, most of these services that you've referenced, from Slack to Google Hangouts and beyond, these are for people who haven't used them before. These are free services. These are something you don't have to buy additional software for or anything. I assume they're probably premium plans, but you don't necessarily need to be buying anything to make these happen, correct?
No, correct. I know for a fact that Slack has the ability to use it. Obviously, Skype has that capability. So there's no cost options, most definitely. If you have a Google account, you can use the video conferencing or the video chat back.
Pretty much everyone has, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of businesses that didn't even know this. But if you have Google hosting your email, kind of the Google Business Suite, it has phenomenal group conferencing capabilities that they don't really advertise. Zoom conference, I know, is one. I think some of these people, too, are, like, offering some specials and some, like, 30 days free usage, you know, in their attempt to try to kind of help. So not only are there free options, but some of the really nicer paid ones, I know that they're offering discounts for businesses to use.
I just wanted to make clear that, you know, people hear that, and I know I got people who are very familiar with this and maybe not, but that be clear. If you want to get into this or you want to see your grandkids or something like that, there are options where you're not going to have to pay for something new. You can definitely do it. And I guess the other thing to mention is if you've got a newer computer, most computers have a camera on them now.
Yes.
So if you bought a laptop in the last, I don't know, 5 years, I assume it's got it on there, maybe longer, or a desktop, it probably does. But if not, Jason, you can do, most phones are going to have that as well.
Absolutely.
For instance, Google Hangouts, can you do via a phone?
Yes, okay. You sure can. You could do Google Hangouts. Like I said, I mean, I think Skype and FaceTime and Google Hangouts, those are probably the top, you know, free, simple ones I would use. But no, I was, again, you know, in the concept of what we did with my mom, which was more of it. But again, my mom was teaching a piano lesson. I mean, so she was, yes, it was feel good and it was about family. But at the end of the day, my mom was doing something that she used to do as a paid service for over 40 years. So, like I said, you know, it's trying to, and you're right, is I think on the tech community, I know I'm in a networking group, BNI, and they're going to an online virtual meeting scenario. And myself and the other IT guy are going to help facilitate. And actually, we're kind of using Zoom conference, honestly. That's how it's going to be done.
Hmm.
So again, some of these things, you know, and our kids, they have Chromebooks. I have a second and a fourth grader, and they got picked up their Chromebooks yesterday, and they were showing it to me. And, you know, I almost feel like to some degree, and what's almost LPS more than UNL, maybe even has better equipped setup because of Google Classroom. By no means this is going to be easy. I mean, I know the kids were devastated yesterday because they were, you know, it looks at this point, there's not really a in sight when they're going to necessarily even get school this year. But again, you know, like I was telling them last time, like, guys, I would be shocked. And again, I don't want to, you know, make any assumptions because, you know, Steve Joel is going to know how all that stuff works better than I. But I'm like, every Chromebook has a camera, a webcam. You have Google Classroom. I have no idea its capabilities, but I guarantee you there's going to be some video conferencing set up there. So I wouldn't be surprised if somehow, some way you're going to see, you know, either some of your classmates, you're going to see your teacher somehow. I said, it's going to be weird, but I just have a feeling that they need to work that out. They need to figure that out. So my message to people, you know, especially for the kids is, you know, hang in there. You know, at first you think you're like on a spring break extended, but you know, ultimately I think the reality starting to sink in that, you know, this is something we're going to have to, you know, hang out for the long haul.
We've all seen it. We've all got kids who want to go to back to school. They want to go back to school and they can't. And heck of a story there, Jason. And they're asking, can I see these people again? It's just insane.
Yep.
Jason, great advice. Let's keep doing this. Let's keep having these conversations and maybe even a little bit more often. If you've got questions you'd like us to discuss, we can get into those. Always shoot us a text at 402-479-1400. Best of luck, Jason. All right. We'll talk to you again soon.
All right. Thanks so much, Jack.
All right. Thank you very much. We're going to grab a break, get a check of sports with Caleb next on KLIN.